We're back. Wow. Yay.
Hello.
We have a lot of people here today. Oh, wow.
Yes, we do.
But before we introduce them, I just need my moment in the spotlight. So the other day we shouted out my favorite podcast and they replied to us. Literally, I can die happy now.
What podcast?
Let's Get Haunted. They're really like a small podcast, so that's why they replied to me. But they were super nice, and they were like, I hope you feel better, because I said I had strep, and very sweet. But enough of that. We're going to start like we always do by introducing ourselves, and like we always do, we have a fun question of the day for y'all. So when you introduce yourself, you're going to say what role you played in this film we are reacting to today. And then you're going to say a weird food combo you really like. So I'll go first. Hi, I'm Angelique Akuna, like Akuna Matata. And I played goth girl Gwen. And my favorite weird food combo is cream cheese with jelly. It tastes like cheesecake.
It's probably really good, though, actually.
Good idea. I like that.
It's really good on a bagel.
I should try that now.
No, yeah.
I thought you just meant like plain, like not on anything.
Oh, just like mixed.
Just like a spoon.
No, actually, like I get like brie cheese with jam and then put it on a pita chip, and that's also.
Oh, that's kind of fancy.
That sounds like super classy.
It's French. Yeah. It's very French.
Yeah.
Oh. You know, I studied abroad there.
Super classy.
Yeah, wow.
So who wants to go next? I think the girls should go next, right?
Okay. Yes. Okay. Hey, I'm Hunter. I played random girl number two, probably. And this isn't kind of weird, but I get a lot of like backlash for it. I like to put my french fries in milkshakes, and people think good. That's weird.
No, I do that all the time. Like that.
I know people who do that.
I just like, I forget who it was. It was Carissa or Sydney. It was like, what are you doing? But yeah, that's all. I don't think I really eat weird food, so that's it.
No, that's a good one. I do that. I do the same thing, and I hate when people get mad because I'm like, it's so good. Mm-hmm. Well, hello everyone. My name is Isabella, and I played Random Girl Number One. So me and Random Girl Number Two had a really intense conversation. Our dialogue was just
in the hallway,
spectacular in the hallway. And honestly, like I feel like now I don't really eat any weird food combinations, but when I was a kid, I was like weird, and I used to always have like, you know, turkey and cheese sandwiches, but sometimes I didn't want to put the turkey and the cheese in it, so I would just have the mayonnaise and the bread.
I
mean, but Isabel, you like pizza with ranch.
What?
That's weird for people.
No, I like, but like, I like it. I like it. But that's like, I mean, it's not a weird combination, but some people don't like it.
I guess, I don't know. I guess I just don't like ranch, so that's probably why.
I love ranch.
And also,
an American
classic.
There's
a lot of ranch flavor in ranch.
Yeah, no, I know. If you put ranch on something, there's ranch on it, and then it's not good for me because I don't like it.
Ranch kind of takes over, like, whatever you put it on, anyway.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Also, Hunter did not only play Random Girl Number Two. She also played our special horse, too. And one quick tidbit.
Oh, and that's the other.
Oh, I did.
The neighbors. We already reacted.
No, she, because, like, you'll see. Remember you'll see. She's in, like, she appears for, like, only a second.
Okay. It's been a hot minute, but I'll remember. Okay.
And then next we have the boys. Any boys want to go first? Introduce yourself.
Okay, so I'm Joseph. I was like the cinematographer, I guess.
Your cine boy.
And my weird food combo is I like putting cheese, like American cheese, on my instant noodles, like instant ramen.
I heard that.
Yeah. Ooh.
That's
that would be interesting.
Yeah.
I've never tried that before.
That was like something that I've done since like I was a kid.
Probably tastes super good.
Yeah, I kind of want to try them.
We'll all try it. Reaction. Okay, who wants to go next?
I'll do it. Hi, my name's Eric. I was the professor at the beginning, I think. And all right, favorite weird food combination. All right, hear me out. Get a hot marshmallow, put it on a graham cracker with some chocolate.
That's literally
more.
Wow.
Name for
I don't
it.
Know about
that's
that.
So that sounds weird. Gross. Why would you do that?
Yeah, that's a stretch.
I can't believe you even said that.
No.
I know.
How do you, I can kick you off the Zoom, right?
No. Oh my God.
Please do.
I actually just like the graham cracker and the marshmallow. Hot take.
So just chocolate?
Yeah.
What about burnt marshmallows?
It's called a deconstructed s'more, actually.
Oh.
Wow.
We're high That's class fancy. In this household.
Yeah. I'm like pretty talented at roasting marshmallows. I can make it like golden brown.
I just put them in the oven.
I just burned Stick them in the oven?
Yeah. Just like on a plate of tin foil, because then like it's not hot and you can just grab it with your hands.
Oh.
Okay, who wants to go next?
Okay. Hi, my name is Ben. I was basically the sidekick character in this movie. I forget his name.
His name is Fred.
Fred.
Oh, yeah.
Fred, that's it. Yeah. No, I'm Reasonable Fred in this movie. And weird food combination, barbecue sauce and mac and cheese.
Oh.
Ooh, that's probably really good. I'm vibing like, with that one.
Yeah. It's a good combo of flavors.
Interesting. I have to try all these after.
I know. This is inspiring me now.
I'll try more after.
You inspire me. Ooh. Roasted.
And then we have finally our lead.
He wants Hello. I'm Max. I play Arthur. I wasn't quite sure whether I played Fred or Arthur. I kind of forgot what you just said, but I'm Arthur. I can't honestly think of like a crazy food combination that I have. I like plantain chips, you know, like the banana like salsa.
That sounds really good.
Oh.
It is really good.
Yeah.
I
thought about that.
Oh wow. Yeah.
It's pretty good.
So I guess we continue on with like a short recap of like production and why this movie was made. I guess the simple
why is this
thing.
A thing?
why does this
why did this happen? I don't know. Anyone want Hunter, Isabella, and Joseph? Do y'all want to explain why? Like, what was the inspiration behind Noir Baby?
I don't remember. Oh,
I'm trying to remember. To be honest,
I guess because our film history teacher Kia, when we did the Noir unit, he did this whole bit that he was a baby who like came out of the womb as like a noir baby, and he did that. He like was like, I'm a cigar. I don't know. So we just thought that was really funny, and I guess we were just looking for like something to do our next visual storytelling project on, and we thought it would be funny to actually like use that. I don't know if there's more to it than that.
It was like, it was one of those things, like I think someone in our major, I think Brandon was like, or like we were just all like, oh, it'd be so funny if we did a movie about Noir Baby, and we're like, ha ha ha, and we were gonna do it for our final, but then we just kind of ran out of ideas, so we're like, let's just do it now. And
yeah,
I need Noir Baby right now.
Exactly.
Right. The world needs it.
You guys right also now. Did it for your final, so it worked in the end.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah,
making a sequel.
There is a sequel.
The esteemed sequel.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty much the whole cast again, but we have another for the sequel. There's another
villain.
There is another
villain.
Yeah,
that we all know and love. But I guess if anyone else wants anything to say about pre-production, shout it out. Like anything you thought, like when we approached you, like why you decided to be an actor in this film.
I can't say no to things. And plus, it was a lot of fun to work with you guys the first time around, so it was good to be back.
Good save. Good save. Thank you.
Nice. Asked, nice. And I was like, no. And then she's like, I'll give you some food. And I was like, all right.
Did I really say that?
Maybe.
Did I get you?
If you believe it happened, I'll take a free meal.
Okay. I'll get you a meal when I come back.
Thank you.
I was in a lot of like visual storytelling projects before this because like I was often just not doing anything, So I had the time to just like be in my friend's projects, but this was definitely the most fun I had like doing one.
My heart.
Wait, that makes you, I know. Oh my gosh. Oh yay. Emotional over here.
It was very fun.
We have a pretty, we have a good time because we don't really know what we're doing. And so it all just kind of comes together after a while and ends up being something pretty great. So
this is like the third film we made. So we were like kind of getting the hang of it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Yeah. But yeah, 3 to 4. And,
and with that, Joseph, do you want anything to say? Want to say anything about pre-production?
I was like, I don't remember anything. Like,
it was a long time ago.
I remember Chinatown being kind of an inspiration.
Yeah. Yes. We used the Chinatown score, didn't we?
Yeah, we used it throughout the whole film. Because I think, Hunter and Isabella haven't seen Chinatown, right?
No.
But Joseph, you've seen Chinatown? Yeah, because me and Joseph saw Chinatown. But you guys haven't, so...
Yeah.
Didn't know that was a movie.
Mm-hmm. Well, with that, I guess we shall
get to the main attraction.
Get to the main attraction. Wow. Look at that.
So, yeah, if you have anything fun to say, just, you know, just start talking or anything like that. Super chill, and then we can explain anything that happens.
Actually, yeah, okay. Okay, let's begin, shall we? Are we ready?
Yeah.
3, 2.
All right, I'm going to kind of try to visualize the point.
So one thing I wanted to mention. Joseph did this, and it was really cool. We did it.
Tinny boy strikes again.
Also, a lot of my family was like, oh my God, because right here, that's me. And a lot of my family recognized me right away. Like, that's you. There you are.
Oh my God, I know those shoulders.
Yeah, they were like, I know that hydro flask, which I lost last year.
Oh yeah.
You know that.
Big rip.
R.I.P. And there's Hunter. Hunter's here.
Yeah, hey, my ratty bun was featured.
I thought this project was called Noir Baby, not 041520.
That's
but with that, I guess we will continue.
I think we're out of markers. I can just.
I'm on it. I'm on it.
Where are you going? We still have another hour of class. Well, he's gone.
I think that's Eric's only scene.
I think it is.
Thank you, Eric.
You killed it, Eric. That's great. Bye. You killed it. No!
Eric, do you have anything to say? Anything? Any experiences?
Reflect on your performance.
Well. I found my marker. No spoilers for the end of the movie, but
holy shit.
That was great.
I love that. Wow. And I guess we have a blooper of that's from the other film where he says Eric says
I say like the wrong word like 20 times.
Wait, was this
what you said? I don't even remember what word it was.
He was trying to say Antoine.
What did I say?
You said Antoine, I think.
That was it.
Oh my God, it still makes you laugh cry to this day.
Oh, wow. I think I had a little like pause afterward, like Antoine.
Yeah, your face.
You're like, yeah, you did.
Oh my goodness. Oh. So good. I guess we will continue. That's Eric's only scene, but he was great. Best part.
Yeah. Full of show.
Lamau. The rest of the movie's over. It can't get any better.
Roll credits.
Featuring Dodge College.
Oh, and Eric's coat. That's Eric's coat.
I actually have that.
Get that. This was actually the hardest scene to film because everyone was going in and out this night. And we were like,
oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I remember this taking a long time.
Yeah.
I do want to say that the costume design for my character, stellar. I like the look.
Mm. That coat.
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh.
For supplying your coat.
He's wearing it.
Wow. So shall we continue?
A piece from the set. Yeah.
I love. Yes.
Thank you.
Dude, what's gotten into you lately? It's been like 2 months and you've already gone off the deep end.
Don't worry. I figured it all out. I want to be a detective.
What?
I'm going to start as a hall monitor in college, and then I'll be a detective. Do you remember when I found the girl's ID the other day?
Well, like, vaguely, but like that doesn't make you a detective.
Of course it does. That's what they do.
Whatever, dude. You do you, I guess. See ya.
Bye.
Oh, wait, I forgot to mention.
The silhouette of me looks really good.
If you remember correctly, yes, Ben is wearing the same thing from our last movie.
That's right. Yeah.
I don't think I planned that out. I think it was just like a total coincidence.
It's like, you know, when animation characters, like the cartoon characters, have like a certain outfit. That was your outfit.
I should have worn that. Like, I have the wrong band shirt on, and I don't have another shirt over it. Like, that's a problem.
I feel like
next time for Noir Baby 2, I'll wear that.
I feel like Arthur isn't planning on being a detective. He's planning on being like the savior of women. Like that dialogue, it's just like he's just like, remember when I found that girl's ID? This is my in. Simp.
Yeah, Arthur's
your
never
analysis.
A girlfriend. Yeah,
Arthur is a simp.
So with that, we will continue.
Have you heard from Gwen lately? She's supposed to be helping out with the project.
I don't know, she like hasn't been in class lately and she hasn't responded to any of my texts.
She's probably just flaking on us. I heard she's a freak anyways.
Yeah, she's always wearing that like grimy black nail polish and sitting in the back of class with all the black clothing.
Yeah, I've heard her roommates don't even come around to her room anymore because she has issues.
Really?
Yeah.
You're so mean, Hunter. Oh my gosh. I know. I like need to relax. I know. There he goes again, though. Savior of women. I know. That's when I was having my like hair crisis.
Yeah.
By the way, Max, I was just like watching, listening to that conversation. Like your performance was really fun there. I enjoyed it.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I was taking like cues from you because I hadn't been like.
Thanks. I kind of like, overacted everything, but thanks.
The chemistry between you two was chef.
Roommate goals. It really was.
Yeah.
And this was filmed in Joseph's room.
Yeah,
so.
That was my dorm room.
I know, what a throwback. This is like, I think this is my favorite scene of the film. One of them. But we did get kind of shit for it from our teacher.
Why?
Really?
Because we didn't show Max's face enough. Because he's all about the close-ups.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but best part right here. Having Contra sponsor us.
Ooh. Back to saving women.
Oh, that looks really nice.
The margarita box, I love it.
That's some, like, great mood lighting there.
Yeah.
That chiaroscuro lighting.
I don't know why it would be a question.
Also, I just want to look at these pictures right here of me. Like, that's me graduating. And that's me during, like, this is the first night of shooting where I took a selfie to make sure my makeup was okay.
Oh, and my if God. You... Oh, is that the thing from Neighbors?
Yes, yeah. This is the thing from Neighbors. We reuse a lot of the things from...
Neighbors with Zac Efron?
The cinematic universe. Yes.
We got Zac Efron to be in our movie.
Ooh.
That's the power that we have.
He was on a break from his Netflix special.
Yeah, exactly. He flew in.
Oh my god. Also with these pictures, I didn't mean to put the black thing on it, like the ink marks on it, but it ended up working out, making it look creepy.
It does.
It looks very cool.
That really production tried. Design.
I know. Wait. I want to pause when Ben comes in. Look at this. It's like Mike Wazowski.
Oh, yeah.
Totally.
Wazowski.
I just remember Isabel and I played not a prank on Joseph, but we put this horse thing on his dumb
prank.
It's a prank. Yeah, well, our type of prank.
Got pranked.
Yeah. Crazy.
What are you doing?
Fred, this is my time to shine. I've graduated from finding markers and IDs to solving an actual murder.
Yes!
You're kidding, right?
And just to embarrass Joseph some more, we also got shit for this.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we got a lot of shit for that.
What, why like, is that?
That wasn't actual, like, stuff that was already there.
Oh,
yeah.
No, it was.
Stuff
yeah.
Oh, I see.
But our teacher was like, you should have moved it or something.
Yeah.
Covered it. And if you...
It's like the realism of it, though. It's
yeah, no.
He's like, meltdown.
Through the life.
And it's if you really pay attention to the sequel, Joseph covers it in the with the blanket.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We can do a deep analysis of what's on Joseph's shelf. There's a shampoo bottle.
Ooh, yeah, let's psychoanalyze Joseph's
shampoo.
Yeah. Is that ramen?
He's clean, unlike those streets.
Is that the ramen you put cheese in?
Yes. Yeah. It is.
But you put the cheese in the shampoo bottle?
That is exactly what I do.
I want extrudable cheese.
Okay. Sorry, I feel like I'm embarrassing Joseph, but like that's our dynamic. That's of our friendship. So we should continue. Shall continue?
No, Fred, I'm dead serious. I heard these girls talking in our class today about how this girl Gwen hasn't been showing up lately. She hasn't been answering her texts. I have a couple theories. Theory number one, she was taken by a cult. Ooh. I looked at her library history.
I felt so bad with my roommate because I brought these in my room one day. And I'm like, damn, they probably think I'm a psychopath because I would just like, cause I think I brought the horse head in the same day in like a box and I just like popped it on my desk. Oh my god.
That transition was pretty solid. Not
I know. This was our teacher's favorite part because like he's like, it's a good.
Wow, I give just credit for that. Okay, that's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Who edited this?
All of us. Mostly Hunter.
Mostly Hunter.
It's very well edited. Props.
Thank you.
Kudos to Hunter. She's our editor.
Yes. She edits all our videos too, so shout out to her.
Who does the Photoshop?
Oh, I do.
Oh, Angelique.
I mean, I have to like ask them before though, like, who do you want to be? What picture do we want? What film do we want? So it's not, I don't take full creative control, but I do the process. So yeah, let's continue.
And she took out books on cults recently. Then I looked in her online history. Don't ask me how. She was looking
for like,
cults near me.
Cult in my room.
Oh yeah.
She fell and hit her head and is dead on her apartment
Wait,
floor.
Wait, I want to look at Hunter's room.
Oh my
room
god,
again.
Look at that yellow floor.
Online history. Don't ask me how.
This is a good Hunter's room. Look at it.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's not my side of the room, so.
I know. Can't but look at this mirror and like the little like hands on it.
Oh, that's the sticky little hands? Yeah.
No. Yeah, hun-
or open closet.
The doors off, is very nice.
And then we got yelled at for it.
Oh, no. That was smart though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Little AC. Had fun with sticky hands last year. She got a large pack of Hunter got a large pack of stretchy sticky hands last year also, and then one of them broke off and stuck behind her nightstand for months, and we didn't realize it until someone shot their film in our room, and they they moved everything around in the room, and then there was just like this decapitated sticky hand on the floor.
Oh my gosh!
I forgot about that.
Also, in this next time. In the next scene, if you look at my eyes, you can see me blink when I hit the floor, and right,
wow.
Yeah.
Number two.
See, watch my
she
eyes.
Fell and hit her head and is dead on her apartment floor.
Dead.
This one is pretty self-explanatory, and I've heard through the grapevine that she's pretty clumsy.
I am pretty clumsy.
Apparently, she trips on the stairs quite frequently. Or three, my personal favorite, a mix of the two. She was murdered.
All right, well, okay then. You know, you have fun with that. I'm gonna go to the library and like study.
No,
and
I need you, Fred. I hear you have a history of picking locks and have never been caught. I need you on my team.
Hold on, how do you know that?
Don't worry about it. No one has to know.
Was this the introduction to the Neighbors universe?
Yeah. We put that scene in because in Neighbors when he's like picking the lock to get into the house.
Yeah.
Wait, what does he use again?
I used that blade of grass. The pin with like the grass thing attached to it.
It was a pen and
And we got caught out for that.
It was a zip tie. If he says he's never been caught, but Arthur knew about it, wouldn't that mean he's been caught?
Arthur just knows everything. Arthur
probably stalked him and like followed his habits of breaking into things, and is like observed from a distance doing detective work. I mean, if anyone catches, it's Arthur.
He probably saw Neighbors.
Yeah.
I watched your movie. I know you.
Or he was like doing it's like maybe
acclaimed hit Neighbors.
Maybe yeah. Arthur just like sits, he has a little balcony and he just watches everyone and like.
Oh,
maybe
like rear window style?
Yeah.
Oh,
no, he saw me picking a lock with my pin with a string on it and zip tie.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's like, okay,
that's my man.
Yeah, he's like, we're going to be good friends. And also, if you pay attention, the next scene looks very familiar to our last movie, if I say so myself.
Oh, yeah.
Fine, you got a deal. So, what you
That door has a key card on it, and I'm picking a lock.
Yeah, wait, I'll go to that one. I'll go to that part.
Maybe a body.
Oh, you can't see it, but
the skeleton. The Gwen written on the whiteboard.
Yeah,
with the horse.
Oh, yeah, our skeleton.
The horse with the pictures. You can't really see it, but yes, this is like a key. You had to like swipe your ID into the door, but we decided to still pretend it was picking locks. And this is our old. This
that's
is
how
me
you
and
know
Hunter's
good.
T. This is me and Hunter's old dorm hall. Wow.
And Eric.
Freshman year. And Eric.
And Max.
And Joseph and Ben and Max.
Well, no, I mean in this specific hall, like first floor.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah. No, it's
that second floor, like
first floor.
First floor.
Let's go.
Honestly, I miss Henley Hall though, because the rooms, the inside of the rooms were so bad that everyone was on the outside of them, so you could just like go meet up with people and have random adventures.
That's really true, actually.
Place to like just run into people. It was a very like social hall.
Yeah,
you slept in the lounge sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, that I always like if I didn't have anything to do, I could just go down to the lounge and there would be like people there.
Yeah,
it was really fun.
Cute.
I kind of miss it to be honest.
Me too.
Yeah.
I feel like it's kind of boring now, though, because, like, no one's allowed in the lounges other than, like, four people at a time.
That makes sense, yeah.
Maybe one day. One day we'll go back.
One day. We'll all invade Henley Hall again.
Take back the money.
This is insane. You're way too serious on this.
I live my life a quarter mile at a time.
Serious. Anyone want to explain that?
who can take a guess into where that line's from?
The mouth of the great Sir Vin Diesel.
Yes.
Oscar nominated Fast and Furious, I think.
Yes, the first one.
Yeah. Yes.
It was our film teacher's favorite line ever.
Yeah,
yeah,
so he just went on.
His taste was
about
just
how good the line was. So we were like, let's pander and use it.
No, literally, I think when we sat down to write the film, it was like, okay, Noir baby, I live my life a quarter mile at a time. Okay,
yeah.
Like, let's write it. And yeah,
like, what does that even mean now that I think about
it? Like, he lives his life like
he's not looking to the
a quarter mile
far
at a
into
time.
The future. He's just like he's just looking at what's immediately there, like the next quarter mile, the next lap around the track or whatnot.
There you go. And well, that's why Ben is a screenwriter.
That's why he's a screenwriter. Yep.
And I think like when he heard our teacher heard this line, he was like, "Hey, I know that line." You're like, yes,
yeah, we just really were teachers' pets, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
appeal to our
pandering.
Audiences.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whatever, dude.
There's the key card.
Ah, okay, got it.
Hunter's room again.
Wait. Is that coffee? Is that Contra there?
Oh, yeah.
That's Starbucks.
Oh, I think that was mine. Oh my god, Game of Thrones.
Oh. The coffee mug. Or the coffee cup, I mean.
I still like how Ben, like, throws the thing after, just like... Love that.
Interesting. Well, yeah, I mean, she may just not care. Most dead bodies are found in the bathroom. Great, now we're breaking into her bathroom. Shit.
No body.
Well, of course there isn't.
Oh no.
Ooh.
Oh no.
The foot shot.
Foot shot.
Who are you? And what are you doing in my room?
Oh my god. What the heck is that? Look at, ew, like that acne. Damn. That makeup.
Look at the pure intensity on Angelique's face.
She's pissed.
I was pissed. Oh, I mean, dad. If I saw two men in my bathroom, of course I'm gonna be pissed. So
I mean, I probably would have run away.
No, but like Gwen's not like that.
Just be like, hey,
she's a fighter.
Yeah, Gwen's a badass.
She's a stand her ground.
She's ready to fight. 7 years of
experience and just investigating.
Is it someone's like audio going?
Is someone else? Yeah, what was that?
Sorry, I'm also in another Zoom call for work. I forgot to turn off my audio.
I was so confused. I thought that was
bastard.
Oh my god. Yeah, how dare you? What?
I hate this frame of me. So no, none of the frames are good of me. Sorry. Let's just continue.
Just keep playing. Just keep
playing. Exactly.
We had good reason to believe that something horrible happened to you.
Don't bring me into this.
Something awful. I was just out of town because my grandmother passed away.
Oh sure, that's what they all say.
Dude, stop it, you're not being funny anymore.
I don't know why you don't believe me. I swear I was out of town. I don't know why you don't believe me.
Oh, you swear, huh? Stop swear it. To your god?
Don't.
Some
creepy
cop leader?
Tell me about it now.
Wow, that was so intense. I got the chills, man.
Well, A, that's the only, I don't know how to talk anymore because I'm just so embarrassed, but A, that was the only, like, part of the film where I was able to be Cinny Boy for a little sec because I was, like, the POV shot, so I was very, it wasn't good because I think the teacher called me out and was like, that's a horrible shot, and I was like,
I liked it.
Yeah,
I think it was like not that, it was like not the whole shot, but it was like one shot where like there's a lot of room above their head, and he was like, I hate that shot. And I was like,
so rude.
This is why I'm not a cinematographer. But yeah, that just happened. Let's see what happens at the very end.
Oh my god, Arthur, what did you do? Okay, all right, we gotta,
so as you see here, oh, I'm dead.
Wow. I mean, look at her.
Look at her. There, that's what like my grades are gonna look like at the end of the semester.
Like, but, literally.
It's funny. So like I think we had a talk about this where I said we should have an insert of like a bloody desk because then no one will get that I died. Because I don't think anyone really got I died. Like, oh, what happened to her?
You didn't really die.
I didn't really die, as you see in like the next film. We
just her lesser actress.
Yeah.
Not actually dead.
And still love this shot though. I guess like my acting
impeccable.
Impeccable.
We gotta call an ambulance.
I'll solve this.
Oh,
before we watch the credits.
I would say the credit sequence too.
Before we have the credit sequence, anyone has a not last words, but like if you want to say anything about the final scene of the film.
Any final words?
I think this just shows the harm that a savior complex can do to people.
Yeah, don't try to be the savior of women, you'll just kill them.
Arthur is the
villain.
Sorry, I think it's a character study. Deeply.
The movie villain versus the actual villain.
Yeah, exactly. Movie villain, horse. Actual villain, me.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, we were thinking that. We were just like, you know, we wanted all the symbolism and all this representation. It was just really, we were going for it.
So
yeah,
with that, we'll watch the our 10 out of 10.
Oh, credit the greens.
Yeah, they're the best.
Yes.
The freeze frame.
The music.
I love the dramatic music there.
I know.
I love the frame that you used.
Yay.
Wow. The inspiration for the credit sequence came from Shrek, I remember. Because they did that at the end of Shrek when they like have them moving and then it stops and then they do the name. So mm-hmm. And it's impactful. Shout out to Shrek.
You guys are true artists. You're synthesizing everything that you've learned from all the movies you've seen and putting them together.
Yeah, Chinatown and Shrek. Exactly. Yeah. Paying homage, you know.
And most film studies
movies of all time.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Also,
I wanted to mention my credit like picture was because when Max was yelling at me, I just started laughing because he's like, oh, that's what they all say. I was like, I think I was like scared because Max has never yelled at me. So I was like, I was super like intimidated.
That was so funny.
Yeah, so I'll stop sharing my screen to see everyone's beautiful faces.
So, no, that was an experience.
That was fun.
That was fun. That was honestly, like, I miss it too.
I highlighted my freshman
year.
Wait, what, Max?
Wait, what?
Chapter 3. We got to do it.
Yes.
Honestly.
You got to complete the trilogy.
Should. Yeah.
We really should. Because the sequel ends on a cliffhanger too, as we will
see.
See
in a different.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And it's time for, like,
I have to comment on my other Zoom call.
Wait, what?
Eric is like in his meeting, so he needs to like.
Has to go to his work meeting.
Me and Owen's character Antoine, we got to team up. Finally.
Yes.
Yeah.
Defeat.
Take down the horse cult.
We actually talked about the sequel a little bit. I think I said like I wanted Simon to be in it to like bully. I really want Simon's character to be in like an opposing cult and like bully Max's character.
Yeah, he was in
Ooh, Battle of the Cults.
Yeah. Wait, what, Max? Yeah, Max, you
Max,
talk first.
Max, go.
I think he's now Ben.
We can't.
I was just asking which Simon we were talking about.
Oh, Simon. I forgot his last name. But...
Simon Weinstein.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah, he'd be fun to call.
Like, I want him to just like.
Dude, they should resurrect the other version of me, so there could be two of me in the in the thing.
Do some like social network science.
Dude, I can have a fight with myself. That would be fun.
Wait
a
minute. Friends.
Guys, we should be writing this down. I'm thinking this right now.
The sequel to Chinatown is about like another Jack Nicholson character. It's called The Two Jakes.
Wait, I didn't know there was a sequel.
There's a sequel?
Yeah, there is. There can be.
I didn't know that. The two Arthurs?
Friends. Two
Antoines, two friends.
Arthur and Antoine.
That's two of everyone.
Simon.
And I think the only thing I got was like I wanted like Arthur to be quietly like doing his work and then Simon's character just like wipes everything off. He's like, hey pussy, what are you doing? just something like that. Just like hardcore just bully him. Or like they're in the same cult, but like Simon thinks he's better than him. But yeah, that's the tea. So in closing, I guess we'll have final thoughts. And you can say your favorite part of working on this movie. I won't go first because I always go first. Give you a sec to think about it.
Yeah, it's a lot to take in.
Thanks.
So okay. If no, I think I have one. So
yeah,
in closing, my favorite part was just working with everyone. I know it's a cop out, but like, I don't know, I guess I felt like I got to know, like I got closer to like Isabella, Hunter and Joseph. And then I got to really know Max more and Ben, working with Ben again. And of course, Eric was always fun to work with. So I just felt like I got to know a lot more people. I felt closer to everyone at the end of it. And now we had a little inside joke, which is fun to talk about. And yeah.
Okay, I think, well, yeah, I mean, I loved working with everyone too. And I think one of my favorite parts though was writing the script. I thought that was really fun. Just because, like, I think after Neighbors, we kind of were excited to do, like, something else that was funny. Because I feel like a lot of other people in our class, or, no, I felt like our class was fun because I don't think any of us were, like, film production majors. So it wasn't, like, super serious. So that was fun. I liked writing the script.
Yeah. It was fun getting to, like, have fun with it because we really did not take this seriously.
No.
But ended up making something really cool. I feel like...
Iconic.
I know. It was amazing. I remember being in Dodge and being, like, kind of nervous the whole time because we thought someone was going to yell at us. Maybe that was just me. But I didn't want someone to come in and kick us out. And we had to, like, deal with all the different people walking around. But it was just fun to just, like, hang out in there and, like, film and just, like, just have a good time and hang out with all these cool people. Is that a cat?
And my cat's.
Oh my god.
Hello. So cute.
I love kitties.
Me too. So, who else? Closing, what was your favorite part of working on the film?
Well, I liked not being hospitalized halfway through this time. That was a good thing. But
okay,
also,
yeah.
I really enjoyed the scene where Angelique dies, no offense. I thought you died very well. But I don't know. It was so much fun to work with Max on that just because Max is like so intense and it was very easy to be like genuinely like, what are you doing? Like that I think we had no trouble doing that scene, but it was like it was just a lot of fun.
Thank you. No, I had a great time working with you as well. Like, a lot of fun.
No.
I know, co-stars.
And it was a lot of fun working with y'all. And I thought it was pretty funny that we filmed, like, in the visual storytelling class. Classroom.
Yeah. We did.
Easter egg.
Kind of blocked that memory out of my head. Just kidding.
We were also nervous that someone was going to go in there and, like, kick it, like, they were going to have a class. Because
didn't we actually kick some people out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we went in, like, in between classes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We did have to kick people out.
Yeah, there's two people working in there. Yeah.
And I had to go in and be like, hey.
Oh, no, weren't they, like, I don't know that we kicked them out, but, like, they were, like, oh, yeah, we can just work in the corner if you want.
Yeah.
And then we filmed for like 2 minutes and then they left.
Yeah, they
were like, that's weird. I gotta go.
Yeah.
That's
just, I was like, what is going on right now?
Like, get out. Then Max and Eric, what are your favorite parts of working on the film?
I think my favorite part was I met Hunter for the first time. I had never seen her before in my life before that. And then she's like, hey, you want a SAG membership someday? And I was like,
and
yeah,
a free meal.
and a free meal.
Yeah.
Oh, a friendship was born.
That's actually not the first time I ever met Hunter. But yeah, the rest is true.
Yeah, you got that SAG membership now. Congrats, that's awesome.
Those screeners, come Oscar time.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You get some good ones.
My favorite part of this was like obviously working with all of you guys and everyone was just like super nice and fun and I got to know all you guys a lot better. Watching Joseph, like Cindy Boy at work, a god.
Yeah,
it's just super fun.
What does your shirt say?
If we stop now, aren't we part of the cover-up?
Oh.
It's for some movie, for a movie called The Report, which I haven't seen, but I think I think it speaks to a lot of things.
Yeah.
I like it.
Wow, speaking some truth. Everyone's speaking truth.
Power.
So with that, if anyone has anything final to say... We're done filming.
And that's it.
We're done not filming.
Yeah,
we're done
thank
with
you
this
guys.
Video. Thank you so much for coming today.
Hopping on the Zoom.
This was a lot of fun. Really fun. Cool.
And I mean, we have a sequel, so.
So be on the lookout for that. Special shout out to the first and ambassadors because they're just really cool. So, yeah. And they know. So, but they love you, first and ambassadors. So, yeah. Thank you so much for coming, you guys. Anyone want to say, like, you know, they better, you know, like, comment, or subscribe? I know some of you aren't subscribers.
If you don't like, Joseph, comment, and subscribe, I'm revoking your SAG membership.
Yeah, you don't want your SAG membership revoked.
With that threat, I think.
Perfect.
I hope all... are you guys subscribers for the four of you?
Channel?
I never saw the other video I was in. I should probably do that.
Yeah, you should. That's over 100 views now. It's our second most viewed video on the channel.
Wow. Is this a YouTube channel?
And you're very popular.
Yeah. And Max?
Is this being recorded?
What, Max?
Yes, this is being recorded.
This isn't SAG, though. Sorry.
Gosh.
I thought I was accepting my Emmy.
You can put this on your reel, your acting reel.
I can.
Yeah.
I already did.
Perfect.
Fair.
So, along with, like, commenting and subscribing, all four of you better also subscribe to our channel.
Fine, maybe I will.
That's a threat.
I'm aggressive, but what
oh my god.
And
as my gender teacher would say, you're not aggressive, you just know what you want.
I want anyone to tell you
you're aggressive, Angelique.
And I want all of you to like, subscribe to the film Said Gorls.
All right.
As we speak.
And with
share. Share the video.
Yeah.
Share with your enemies. Share with your friends. Share with your lovers. Share with your haters.
Share with your lovers.
If you're in a cult, share it with a cult member.
Share with the cult member. Yeah. Share with your dog. My dog's here. Wanna say hi?
Aww.
He's like, ew, what the heck?
My tiny castle is here.
Tiny castle.
Share with your tiny castle. Share with your frog. Sure. Share with your cat.
Cat, wait, I'll show Kitty.
My dogs aren't here.
Kitty.
Kitty. Yeah.
If we're showing our animals.
Wow.
She's like, what?
Share with everyone. Share with your state. Joseph's in Texas. Share with the state of Texas, Joseph, our video.
Oh my god.
The entire state, okay?
The state in our country.
Shout out to Texas. I feel
like this would be very popular in Texas.
Yeah, you never know.
So with that, we shall end the video. Thank you all for coming.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.